There's breaking news just coming in. Two more civilians have been shot dead by terrorists in Kashmir Valley. Two migrant laborers have been shot dead in Kulgam. Terrorists have stormed into the house of migrant laborers in Kulgam. That's the latest coming in. So now the count has increased. Two more civilians shot dead by terrorists in Kashmir Valley. If we have Ashraf with us, let's go straight across to Ashraf to bring our viewers up to speed in terms of what is going on, because you're seeing a spate of targeted killings right there in the valley, which is being, of course, backed by Pakistan. Terror bleeding Jammu and Kashmir, that's our top focus. And the breaking news just coming in, incidentally, is that two more civilians, we are just getting this news, they've been shot dead by terrorists in Kashmir Valley. Ashraf is now joining us. Ashraf, we already knew that in the month of October, 9 civilians were killed. Now, add to this, 2 more civilians been killed. The tally is just going up. All right, we'll re-establish that connection right there to Ashraf Vani in just about a bit. These are live visuals that are coming in from the valley at the moment. Terror bleeding Jammu and Kashmir. Live visuals on your screens right now. Two migrant laborers have been shot dead in Kulgam. Ashraf has more details on what is happening, because this information is just trickling in as we speak. Two more civilians being killed in Kashmir Valley. Two migrant laborers shot dead in Kulgam. That's the latest coming in. The number of civilians and soldiers recently killed in the targeted killings in the valley is increasing. In the month of October itself, we had reported earlier as to how 9 civilians were killed. And now we have information coming in. 2 more civilians killed in the valley. Terror bleeding Jammu and Kashmir. The spate of targeted killings that are being witnessed in the valley, it remains to be a cause of huge concern for the nation. We'll wait for a reaction coming in from the Union Home Ministry on how they're planning to contain this particular situation, because this situation seems to be escalating at the moment. If we have Ashraf with us, Sunilji Bhatt is now joining us for the very latest details. Sunilji, 9 civilians killed was our initial report. 2 more civilians have been killed is the breaking news that is coming in. A total of 11 civilians, and please correct me if I'm wrong, there are tensions escalating in the valley. How does the Home Ministry respond to this in terms of resolving and finding a plausible solution to these targeted killings that we're seeing in the valley?
Well, Cheti, terrible, terrible news is coming in from South Kashmir's Kulgam district. 2 more non-local laborers have been shot dead by the terrorists in the Kashmir Valley. So now the police force is on the spot. Additional security is being provided to the laborers who are working in the Kashmir Valley. But it's a matter of huge concern. Again and again, these incidents are taking place. Non-locals are being attacked. And in the recent past, we have seen that whether it's Kashmiri Pandits or Kashmiri Sikhs or non-locals, they are being killed by terrorists, and it's a matter of huge concern for the security agencies. Recently, we saw that the security review meetings were taking place in Jammu and Kashmir, and the J&K administration had assured that such things won't happen again and security will be provided to the vulnerable sections of the society. But unfortunately, time and again, non-locals are being attacked. Kashmiri Pandits are being attacked. And in 1990, we are aware of what had happened. An entire community was driven out of their homes from the Kashmir Valley by the terrorists. And now similar kind of things is taking place. Targeted killings are taking place, and it's creating fear psychosis among the non-locals, among the Hindus, as well as among the minorities.
Very right in saying it's creating fear psychosis in the valley right there. We leave it at that. Thanks for joining us with our ground report at the moment.